beta brain into our passing that we've been doing. Good work, Andy.
Thank you.
So if Andy's on his side in, like, let's say you're here.
Yeah.
So again, the beta range, what's up?
Yeah, we can face that way.
Andy, you're looking out, buddy.
I took an intro to film course in
college. Ooh, thanks. That's great.
I have no knowledge of it. Anybody who's seen the Fluff Report knows that I know nothing about film. So from the idea with mid-range is that, again, if I'm at long range, usually that's going to be more like where we're both fighting each other is the end of our extremities, like hand to ankle, or using his feet against, like, my legs or somewhere far away from him. As I get closer, this is more like knee-to-knee, elbow-to-elbow range. And that's not like, you know, like a specific thing, because each of these ranges is kind of elite. But generally, you're thinking, when my elbows and my knees are roughly battling his elbows and his knees, you can consider that like a mid-range. And then close range would be where some part of my torso is fighting some part of his torso. So for example, if I'm trying to get my shoulders to his hips, or my shoulder to his shoulders, or my hips to his hips, etc., that's a closer range. So when we're at mid-range, a lot of the time, last week, for example, what we dealt with was doing leg weave and then doing leg drag when somebody's using their knees and arms as frames and shields. Today we're going to go into what's called long step passing, which is mainly a gi style of passing. And we're going to start from a little bit more specific position than we did last week. So right now I have one knee up and I have my leg out to the side, like in a cut pass position. And he's using his knee to keep me away. So I'm taking a collar grip and I'm taking a hands grip here, low on the sleeve of his pants. And I can grab like this, or if it's quicker, I can grab like this. And what I'm looking for with these grips is when I'm here and here, this upper body grip allows me to keep him from moving his upper body too far away from me. Same thing that we did last week with the leg weave passing. And then this grip allows me to hold his leg in place as I bring my hips above his shoulders. So when I'm here, I'm burying my head in his chest. I'm sitting my hips back. And then from here, the first version that we're gonna do is driving forward so my partner's shoulders go flat to the mat. And then either taking me on belly or taking side control, hugging the head and underhooking the leg. So here and here, I have the collar grip right around collarbone level. As I bury my head in Andy's chest to try to keep the shoulders flat, I'm bringing my hips higher than the shoulders. My leg steps out. And then from here, my goal is to drive off the mat to flatten the shoulders out, block his hip with my knee, grab the mat, and under the leg. So the whole thing, when you do it, happens fairly quickly. Here, like this, my hips are higher than the shoulders. As I drive forward to flatten them out, knee goes to the hip, controlling the head, and underhooking the leg. Let's partner up and start with that basic idea, and then we'll build from there. Thank you.